I'm Rachel Johnson with UCSB Athletics, here with Gabe Vincent of the men's basketball team. Let's go meet a Gaucho. I'm here with Gabe Vincent.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, how's it going? How's the team looking this year, or what's the season look like?
We're really young compared to the teams in the past, but it'll be an exciting year because we have a lot of talent, a lot of athleticism, so it'll be exciting to see the young guys get out there and run up and down the floor and play above the rim.
Okay. What do you see as your role on the team this season?
I think my role has increased every year. My freshman year is kind of we were playing all around Al and dropping the ball into there and letting him go to work. And last year, my role increased a little bit with the scoring output and having to defend better and be more of a leader. And with Mike and John leaving, you know, it's kind of up to me and Eric now to lead the team. And my scoring output has to be more and just try to lead in every way, on and off the court.
Do you have any pregame rituals?
I try to keep a routine as far as, you know, getting taped at the same time, and coach makes sure we eat at the same time, like 4 hours before the game. But I like to get a workout in or two in before the game and get a sweat going. If I can, I take a nap, but often I can't fall asleep, so I'll just be up working out. But that's about it. Nothing too crazy.
I understand your parents have been really supportive of your whole career here at UCSB. Can you tell me a little about them?
My parents have definitely been supportive of me, as they have my whole life. But definitely since I came to Santa Barbara, they've made a point to come out to the games, and they haven't really missed one yet. I mean, they've been on the road traveling with us, which is nice. They have a busy schedule, obviously, when we're not in season, as they're both psychologists, but my dad runs a foster family agency in Merced County, and that keeps him busy most of the time. And I'm thankful that he's able to have time to take off and travel with us. As well as my mom, who runs her own psychology business and has people working under her. So it's nice they're able to make time and, you know, get out here and spend some time with me. It's always nice, you know, seeing a friendly face up in the stands wherever you go.
The life of a student athlete is really hectic. Can you walk us through an average day in your life?
Usually I like to wake up early, get my day going, whether it be to work out or to do a little extra homework I didn't finish the night before. In the past, I've really struggled with sleeping, so this year I've definitely made a point to try to sleep more, try to get a full 8 hours. And then if I do work out, I'll work out, then shower up, go to class, try to get a quick bite with one of my teammates probably, get some quick treatment before practice, and then, you know, before then, it's usually practice time, and after that, be followed by more treatment, just trying to take care of the body, and, you know, it's a long season, try to stay on top of things. And go out, eat again. It feels like we're always eating. And then do some more homework and get ready for the next day.
When you do get a little bit of downtime, what do you and your teammates like to do?
Like I said before, we spend a lot of time together. So usually when we're all together after practice or something and we have that free time, we'll get the controllers out and start playing some NBA 2K. Those games get pretty competitive and gets pretty animated in there.
Which teammate would you like to play against most?
If I'm looking for an easy win, probably Sam Walters, just because he doesn't play it that much. You know, he likes to spend time on the beach. He's a big surf guy. He's from Santa Cruz. So probably for an easy win, I'd play him. But either Eric Childress or Tito Osifeso are probably one of the two better players on the team because, I don't know, they get a lot of time in on it. They get their practice in. They're just nice. Like, they're just way too good at that game.
We're looking forward to an exciting season this year. How do you see your role changing on the court?
Like I mentioned before, we're a younger team with a lot of new faces. So I think my role as far as a leader will change the most. Me and Eric being one of the only two returning that have played a lot of minutes and been here for a while, definitely looking at us to lead. And I think Eric's definitely ready for that, being a senior point guard. I'm very confident in the year he's going to have and very confident in him and how he'll be this season. Regarding the new faces, we have a lot of new freshmen, but we also have a transfer coming in that I played with, you know, 4 years ago in high school, travel ball. So we've had a lasting relationship, and, you know, we never thought we'd end up on the same team again, and here we are. So we're pretty excited to get back on the court, and it should be nice to see Jalen back active in the same uniform. I'm just glad I'm not playing against him.
Do you have any advice for young athletes who would potentially want to be future Gauchos?
I think it's the pretty generic answer of, you know, work hard, be patient, trust the process, and stay focused. I mean, focus is huge, whether it's, you know, on the court, off the court, in the classroom, because, I mean, to be able to play at this level, you have to have the grades. So that's important to be able to be academically strong as well as athletically strong.
What drew you to UCSB over all the other schools that were recruiting you?
It was tough. It was a stressful process, definitely in high school, trying to figure out where I wanted to go, because like I said before, I have those goals of playing in the NBA and the league, and definitely where you go to college and where you can develop at this next level plays a role in that. So it was tough at first until I came on my visit to Santa Barbara and got to be on campus and walk around campus and see what it was like to be a student here, get to meet the team and the coaches, and that's when I really just fell in love with it. And, you know, I got to know the guys better. And before I even got here, I felt like I was already a part of the family. And so it was huge. I mean, just coming out here and seeing what it was like, I fell in love. And at that point, you know, no other school really had a chance.
That's a wrap from the Thunderdome. We look forward to seeing you on November 6th for the kickoff of an exciting season. For tickets, visit UCSBGauchos.com or call 805-893-UCSB.